Hello and welcome to Learn It All. Today we are going to look at a couple of stocks that ran on Friday. And the first one is going to be SNOA. It has a very low float of 1.6 million and outstanding shares at 1.5 million. It was up 150% pre-market. And if we look at the daily chart, it had a resistance around the $20 mark. It was running up on a positive catalyst, but because it was up so much pre-market, I did not really jump in to it when market opened, and I was waiting for it to break the pre-market resistance. And once it broke the pre-market resistance, I took a small trade because I was not confident, and I closed my positions right around here. Because I was smelling FOMO and there were multiple stocks running on Friday. And I knew the daily resistance was around $20 and I wasn't sure if it's going to break it. So I didn't have the confidence. And that's why I closed my positions around here. And later in the day, it did not get towards the $20 and kept going down. The second runner was PHIO, which was also up 150% pre-market. And this is also a low float stock, 4.3 million shares, and shares outstanding is around 1.7 million. This had already moved from $2.25 to $6. And if we look at the daily chart, you will see that it had almost closed the gap on the daily chart. This was the gap that was created back in February. That's why I was not sure if it's going to even go further up. But I was watching it when market opened and it really did not do anything and kept crashing down. No trades on that one. And the last one you all have been waiting to hear about is ADAP, which moved from $5 to $12 pre-market. And let's look at the daily chart. It had a resistance at $6.50, which it had broken. And the next resistance was around $14. So it had a chance to really move up to $14. But what went wrong is that there were multiple movers on the same day. And it is difficult for one stock to really keep moving up when there are multiple runners as a traders get distributed across. So when market opened, it did not do anything and it crashed down. Later in the day, it tried to move up. It broke the pre-market high just by a little bit, but really did not go further beyond and just did not show enough strength to keep moving up. And really, when you see stocks moving so much up on pre-market, this is pure FOMO. And I'm afraid to touch these kind of stocks when they move so much up on pre-market. The reason for this FOMO could be because of the latest stocks that have been moving up 300, 400%. But stock moving up that much pre-market, that's insane. That is it for today, guys. Keep watching my videos and leave a comment. And don't forget to like, subscribe, and click the bell icon for instant notification on new videos.